I campaigned in my youth against Greece's entry into the European common market. That was in the 1970s. Then in the 1990s, I campaigned against entering the Eurozone. And I'm not changing my mind. I'm not apologizing for this. This was the right campaign. Once you, if you're outside, stay outside. But if you've entered, getting out will not take you to where you would have been had you not entered. It's a question of statics and dynamics. I would much rather we had stayed out. But once we're in, we have to fight the corner. Now, in the case of Britain and Brexit, the reason why I would oppose it if I were a British voter, and the reason why I campaign in Britain against Brexit, is twofold. Firstly, the notion that you're going to reclaim your sovereignty by getting out while staying in the single market and allowing Brussels to decide industry standards, labor protection standards, and environmental protection standards is absurd. Effectively, you give jurisdiction and sovereignty in all those matters to an alien force from which you are withdrawing, and you let them decide in your absence. And that's a problem with Norway. You are not really out. You are in the single market. Mm-hmm. So you have forfeited sovereignty to an alien force. This is not exactly an act of independence. Now, and the second reason why I'm against Brexit is because, at the moment, looking at both sides of politics, of the argument, the Leave campaign and the Remain campaign, they behave as if the European Union is a given out there, a club. It's like a golf club. Do we want to be a member of it or not? But it's given. Whether we are a member of it or not, it will be there. It's not given. It is disintegrating. And Brexit would speed up the disintegration, and that disintegration would create developments that would be detrimental to Britain, and therefore, this is what I refer to as the Hotel California dictum. You can check out anytime you like, but you can never leave.
Yeah.